Huh?
What do you mean?
Short, like on your want-wants. You know what I mean? Play them all the way through. Like, some of them you're like, you're cheating.
Oh, am I?
Yeah.
We're up here in Fort Collins, Colorado, one more time, making the fourth record for Rise Against here at the Blasting Room, and that is Bill Stevenson, legendary punk producer, drummer, extraordinaire of such bands as Black Flag, Descendants, and All, and personal mentor.
I don't want to go back to Boom Boom there. Once you guys hit halftime, I say you stay there and finish out the thing.
But Back to Boom Boom is the name of the record, Bill.
No, just listen to me.
Bill and Jason knows better than we know ourselves,
you
know?
At least if you listen for kind of what I'm thinking.
Okay. So we're kind of like on autopilot when it comes to writing new songs. You know, when we get into that mode, it's just second nature on, you know, getting on the same page. And Bill and Jason are right there with us.
They're both just, they understand where we're coming from. They're both punk rock guys. They've been in punk rock bands. They're musicians, they're drummers. And it just sort of felt natural when we came here. They sort of immediately got like what we were going for and what kind of music we wanted to play and how we wanted it to sound.
I don't think that Phil should even be there.
It's
like,
pretty
it's fucked on the vocal. And I think this is better on the vocal. I'm never the guy to take out a fill, mm-hmm. You know. Fuck that. But I would try the pa tu tu pa on one chorus.
You don't have to do this. I'd forgive you if you don't.
Oh, that's something like that.
You don't have to do this. I'd forgive you if you don't.
The new record, it's coming along really well. I think we're the creative process is pretty much it's pretty much done. You know, created the bones, like the skeletal structure of all the songs, and hammered a lot of stuff out here in this room, and now we're just kind of attacking the nuts and bolts of it.
The normal chorus, but I didn't know, man, that chorus, something about it, I feel like when it rips balls a little bit, it feels good somehow, but I know the verse, I don't think we want the verse to go too much faster, we'll lose that, just kill. What are your guys' thoughts on tempo on this?
It's been a long process. We've written a lot of songs here. We had songs written before we came here. And so we basically sit in this room and there's another room down the hallway and we just play the songs over and over and over until we figure out what's good, what's bad, what we want to keep.
So it's rad. It's, you know, it's almost like an assembly line and everyone's adding a different piece to it as they pass it down. So by the time you get it, someone's like totally put all this cool stuff on it, you're like, this is nothing like it started, you know what I mean? But it's so awesome, and I want to add this and this, and then give it to the next person and see what they're going to do. And then when it gets through all of us, you know, guys like Andrew are going to be in the back room just like, I hear this weird guitar part, I'm just going to play it really quick and play it for you guys, you know? And then it's like, that's amazing, you know? And so it's...
That's what the beauty of the whole process is, the recording process. You just keep layering and layering, so you can't really make a judgment yet, you know, they're all kind of where you're listening to them all, you're going, this is all really good. And
I think we've achieved the best bass and drum tones like we've ever gotten. So that's, as long as we keep doing that, you keep topping the one before, you know.
We're always kind of pushing to find something new, a new idea, or a new way to, you know, insert a pre-chorus into a song, a new way to do a different kind of bridge. I'm trying to push the songs in terms of lyrics and vocals and try different things, you know, and so I guess this record is just a sort of growing process from all of that. It's great to come here because, you know, as much as Bill and Jason and everybody here at the studio is our family, so are a lot of people in this town, and we've known them for years and hung out and eaten at their restaurants and shopped at their stores and hung out at their parties and gone to their bars or whatever, and so
that makes a lot of fun, because when you have a long day here, just working hard at the songs, it's good to get out and just kind of unwind and just get your head out of the songs for a minute, you know, to find some sort of clarity. And we did that.
Guys, and then we're going to try it.